Australians too quick to judge? Well, NRL players are often subject to assumptions of guilt, as former NRL star Hazem El Masri knows very well. Even after an unblemished record as a player and outstanding record of community service, many were ready to assume that allegations of domestic violence against him were well founded. So are we too quick to presume guilt? That's our daily dilemma this morning. And John Caldwell joins us.
Good morning.
Good morning, John. Hazem El Masri was a very interesting case, wasn't it?
It was. I think the question everyone's asking is, are we still innocent until proven guilty? I don't think we ever were. I think if you look back as far as even Lindy Chamberlain, for example, I mean, we want to believe someone's been caught as quickly as possible. Trial by public opinion, by media, has always been a thing. I guess it's worse now with social media, so we get everyone's a judge and a jury and we get their opinions fired quick and fast. In this particular case, I think what's a shame is he was innocent. It smeared his record. And again, with social media, that's going to be out there forever from now on. But if you look at the flip side of that, I think if you look at the case with Tara Brown on the Gold Coast last year, she reported domestic violence to the police. They didn't believe her and she was killed a few days later by her partner. So, I mean, which way do we go with that?
I think in terms of Hazem El Masri, a lot of the reporting I saw actually was almost disbelieving in its nature. Said, this can't be right. And thankfully it wasn't, because anyone who knows him knows he's an upstanding guy. But is it not just that the mob just loves a public crucifixion? There's a reason why big crowds turn out to hangings. You know, no one shows up to see someone doing their job every day and not breaking the law. So people just, whether it's someone who's been accused, not found guilty, or whether it's someone who's found guilty, or whether it's just someone who's just said something once, and we see people jumping all over social media just because of an off-the-cuff comment, and just, it's almost baying for blood. People love to see someone torn down.
Yeah.
There's part of that, but I think too that the point you make, John, about the case in Queensland, that I think there are particular allegations that really, for some particular cases, you think, oh, that is just so horrendous. Yeah. And so, because in the past they might have been overlooked, that's why people then think, well, OK, they must be guilty of that.
Yeah, we need to dig this one
a bit further.
I think if people don't react the way most people think they ought, that's when they start getting judgmental. So in the case of Lindy Chamberlain, because she didn't cry in the court, that was held against her.
Yeah.
You know, and just because she's stoic, people couldn't see that side of Lindy Chamberlain. And you're right. I mean, the social media goes out of its mind. I mean, it says the most dreadful things about
people. And you don't know what advice you're getting from lawyers either. That's the same in the case of the McCanns. They were told, don't cry, because the captor might see this and get off on that. And so you don't know what they're being told. But, of course, yeah, social media jumps all over that. But how do you rein that? How do you rein social media in?
I think also it depends on what people find more important. So some people go, oh, it's domestic violence, and let's jump to conclusions. Mm. And yet when we talk terrorism laws, people are really happy that people are allowed to be kept longer and interrogated longer and be guilty until proven innocent. So domestic violence for me personally is a huge thing, and I think every single case should be investigated right through. So
let's look at some feedback on this discussion this morning. Firstly, let's go to Louise. Definitely a lynch mob mentality going on, trial by social media. And this from Michael: we judge people on the way they look, the political party they belong to, their race, and even the football team they belong to. Mm. Not only does innocent until proven guilty not exist, in many cases, it doesn't even matter. John, thank you so much.
Thank you. Thanks.